Oh, I'll read from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in the hope of the glory of God. And hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, who has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, and that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. And indeed, the Father seeks such people to worship Him. God is His Spirit, and those who worship Him must worship in spirit and truth. The woman said to Him, I know that the Messiah is coming, the one called the Christ. When He comes, He will tell us everything. He said to her, I am He, the one speaking with you. Many of the Samaritans of that town began to believe in Him. When the Samaritans came to Him, they invited Him to stay with them, and He stayed there 2 days. Many more began to believe in Him because of His word, and He said to the woman, we no longer believe because of your word, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The British theologian Frank C. says that people everywhere are crying out for hope. I'm crying out for hope, crying out for purpose and meaning in life. People have a spiritual thirst and that needs to be satisfied. What does the world do with this thirst? France, she compares it to what others do to entertain or distract a crying child who gets separated from his or her mom by giving the child chocolate or candy. The world is trying to keep us preoccupied. It is as if the world were telling us, are you bored? Here is the telephone, talk to someone. Or here's the television or gadget, get entertained. Or here's the computer or Facebook, surf and chat. Indeed, the living stream of invention has served itself very well to keep us preoccupied and to keep us from remembering that which is troubling us. In today's Gospel, Jesus asks the Samaritan woman for a drink of water. And maybe they ask, who is this woman? She was a Samaritan, and during that time there was a deep-seated resentment between the Jewish people and the Samaritans that was already centuries old in Jesus' time. Also, being a woman in her time, she'd be silent in presence of a rabbi, and she was known as a public sinner because of her multiple marriages, and therefore shunned by a neighborhood which might explain her solitary trip to the well at the moment, which is the hottest time today, and nobody else was around. Indeed, the Samaritan woman was a person on the margins of the society in which she lived. Jesus' simple request for ordinary water becomes an occasion for Jesus to talk about another kind of water. Jesus offered the Samaritan woman his living water. Whoever drinks this water get thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I will give him will never be thirsty again. Indeed, Jesus reaches out to her as he does so to us because he knows her past, and Jesus knows our past. We may ask if it is true that we all have spiritual thirst that needs to be satisfied. What is this inner emptiness that we all have? Have we paid attention to this thirst? What do we do to quench our thirst? St. Augustine says that our hearts are made for God, and they will not resist, but they will not rest until they rest in God. Another writer puts it by saying that our hearts have a God-shaped hole in them that only God can fill. This should somehow lead us to the realization of a great tragedy in our lives. We are trying to feel the Godship all in our hearts with something other than God, or with something less than God. Thus we try to find the satisfaction in loving other worldly ways. We find the satisfaction in the fulfilling relationship, or in the immoral acts, or even in the scandalous entertainment, in the world of achievements, or in the world of accomplishments. This Sunday is an invitation that we may realize, an invitation that we may take to heart and live by the truth, that Jesus in Him alone can satisfy the thirst in our hearts, that Jesus alone can feel the Godship all in our lives. And this is very important as we continue to protect ourselves, especially this very trying hard times of this fear of the virus. God will definitely quench our tears. God will definitely give us the hope that will be joy, that will be the assurance, that will save us, that will deliver us from the present challenging situation. Let this mental system lead us to the realization. But first, we have to admit that the memories they follow the Lord. We are trying very hard to get ourselves occupied and preoccupied with things that keep us from remembering our deepest thirst. Today, this Sunday, we are reminded that in the face of all of these struggles, all of these problems, all of this fear of the virus, Jesus and Jesus alone can satisfy the thirsty and hunger in our hearts. And as we move into the official, then there was a concern in Nostra Seguridad y Salud, or for more, not in a story of Santa Cruz, for lo que quiero hacer, es que me ayuden a avisar para que hagamos que pasemos juntos este problema de salud. Y yo creo que Dios continúa con nosotros, incluso en este momento tan difícil. Que Dios nos está enseñando el camino. Mantén tu fe y Dios lo haga haciendo la fe. Brothers and sisters, let's keep the faith, because in that time we will surely work this through.
Spirit, and rose again the third day in accordance with the scriptures.
sing up and run away. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God, give us the living water of our true salvation, that has been the call for all who trust for his divine life.
That Christians everywhere may respond to the word of God during this holy season, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's people may worship Him in spirit and truth, and reject the temptations of evil, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have rejected God may turn to Him and know His loving mercy in their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through sincere confession of their own sins, those gathered here and everywhere may be at peace with God and one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may remain healthy during the season of flu and the coronavirus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O Son and Father, through Jesus we have entered the life of grace, and your Spirit has been poured into our hearts. This is the prayers we offer in faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
grace and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy creatures. Be with us, O Lord, in this sacrificial offerings, and grant that we may beseech, pardon for our sins, may thee grant to forgive our anger, through Christ our Lord.
Oh, yeah.
art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from the evil, graciously grant peace in all days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we are in the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of our Jesus, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to our apostles, peace and leading on his day, look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity, in accordance with your will, for the reign forever.
Whosoever dreams,
Let us pray. As to the supervision of things taken in hand, in our hearts to us alone, for the burden comes from us, we have the agent of your Lord, that by his name, God of God in us in this mystery, may come to true completion, through Christ our Lord.
Most sacred Mother Jesus,
in our
incarnate
Mary,
Saint
Joseph.